I'm Caitlin, and I did my Petchakusha on Nella Larsen. Starting off with my thesis statement, in the novel, The Passing, by Nella Larsen, Larsen used her own personal experiences with her struggles with racial identity into her writings at a time where other writers and novelists did not do so. Who exactly was Nella Larsen? Nella Larsen was a novelist and short story writer known for her two completed novels, Quicksand and Passing. She was a quiet force within the Harlem Renaissance as one of the seven writers. She previously studied to become a librarian and nurse. Nella Larsen struggled with her sense of belonging ever since she was a child. She was born on April 13, 1891 in Chicago, Illinois. Her mother was a white Danish immigrant and her African American father was from the Danish West Indies. Her father passed away in her early life, sadly, while her mother remarried to a white man within a year. This, however, caused Larsen's issues with racial identity and sense of belonging, being raised in a household with two white parents as a mixed race child. Nella Larsen moved down south and studied at Fisk University briefly for a whole year, from 1907 to 1908, before moving to Denmark to study at Copenhagen University to take classes while visiting relatives. After about 2 years, in 1912, she moved back to the United States to study to become a nurse. In 1915, she completed her degree and she worked at Booker T. Washington Tuskegee Institute in Alabama as a nurse. After deciding she wanted to become a nurse, she returned back to the United States and studied at the Lincoln School for Nurses in the Bronx. This was the first school for Black students who were trained to become a nurse in the North. In this photo shown here, you can see that Nella Larsen is located in the second left in the front row. In 1919, Larsen and Elmer Imes, a Black physics professor, got married and moved to Harlem in 1922. They both mutually were involved politically and intellectually with the Harlem Renaissance, which is what inspired Larsen to become a writer. Larsen was a novelist and a short story writer in the Harlem Renaissance. She was brought into the movement with the help from her friend Carl Van Vechten. He helped her get two completed novels published by Alfred A. Knopf. The legacy brought awareness to the struggles African Americans face and how they were stereotyped. Nella Larsen is well known for her two novels, one of which we've discussed and read in class, known as Passing. This novel discusses the theme of belonging within racial communities, families, and relationships. Passing takes a look into how Black characters in the novel manage to pass as white, taking advantage of the privileges that white people tend to take for granted. Her other novel is called Quicksand, which also talks about the theme of belonging and is very similar to Nella Larsen's experience throughout her childhood.
Pardon me, I don't mean to stare, but I think I know you.
Claire?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to find out the history of the blonde you've brought along.
She's a girl from Chicago I used to know.
Princess from Chicago.
Things aren't always what they seem.
I'll be damned. Lots of people pass all the time.
It's easy for a Negro to pass for white. I'm not sure it'd be so simple for a white person to pass for color.
So you haven't ever thought to?
What?
You ever thought of passing?
No, why should I? Now I have everything I've ever wanted.
This is my husband, John Bellew. Does he know?
But you dislike Negroes, Mr. Bellew.
No, not at all. I hate them.
The novel Passing is very significant because it talked about very controversial topics that other writers had yet to discuss in their writings. In this quote, it wasn't that she was ashamed of being a Negro or even having it declared. It was the idea of being ejected from any place, even in the polite and tactful way in which the Drayton would probably do it, that disturbed her. I found this quote to be really powerful and interesting because it showed how much fear these people faced during this time and how white people really tend to take the fact that they didn't have to worry about that for granted. Nell Larson had a few accomplishments throughout her writing career. She was the first African American to win the John Simon Guggenheim Memorial Foundation. She also won the Harmon Foundation Bronze Medal Second Prize in 1929. Larson went through a divorce with her husband while dealing with plagiarism allegations and had a decrease in book sales due to the 1929 stock market crash. She discontinued her writing career and returned back to nursing for her remaining decades in the work field. Nell Larson passed away on March 30th in 1964 at age 72, alone in her apartment in Brooklyn, New York. Today, many critics consider her to be the greatest novelist of the Harlem Renaissance, and her work continues to be read nationally and internationally.